rode the barge down, me and my friend Aziz, we rode it down the Nile River, and then we stopped in all of these different places and kind of explored the story in each of these places. This is a cargo ship. It doesn't have any place to sleep. So you had to like just sleep on the top of the deck with the people. There's no bathrooms, you know, I mean, people just, you know, pee in a bucket and throw it over the side. And if you don't have food, you won't eat, so you gotta bring your own food on the boat. I mean, it's a kind of a really cool experience to be there with all these Southerners who were going back home. We would stop in these different places, and it was the rainy season, so many times it rained on board this cargo ship, and when it rains, it's like a torrential rain, and there's no place to hide from it at all. You will just, you and everything you own will be soaked. The camera stopped working at some points, and like, I didn't have a camera for several days because it just died. From the rain, and we went into the Shilla Kingdom. We went into these areas by small boat, and we had to walk for days to get to some of these stories. Walking through swamps, actually, where there's no proper soil to walk on. You know, there were leeches and all kinds of insects, and I don't like worms, so we had leeches sucking our blood, and you know, walking for days, you know, without anything to drink or anything to eat. And when you finally got to a location where there would be civilians, the water would be rainwater that they had collected, and it's for them. And so if you drink it, you're depriving them of it. You know what I mean? So it was just like really, it was a tough time.
Especially because these people were dislocated, right? Did they?
Yeah, in the Shilla Kingdom, basically there was a rebellion going on there, because there's many rebellions in Sudan, and often they're supported by different proxies and forces. And this rebellion was a kind of a Shilluk tribal rebellion against the Dinka-dominated government of the south. The Dinka is the dominant tribe of southern Sudan. And so what the Dinka-dominated government did was go in and punish all the Shilluk. They just went in and did burnings of all the villages in the kingdom, like scores and scores, I don't know, maybe more than 25 villages were burnt to the ground. And they raped all the women in these villages and the little girls, even girls that were so small that, you know, they're toddlers that were raped. Mass rapes went on. And what I found really disturbing was, I had done some research and I knew that I would find something in the Shilla Kingdom that wasn't going to be pretty. I just didn't know how bad it was going to be. And when, so the film, it's sort of like, I don't know, my own like Heart of Darkness kind of thing, where you sort of, things get worse and worse as you go down the Nile and you go deeper into the story of this country. I was really shocked at how bad it was. And